Travis is cast about what we call collision. Collision is what happens. Previously, we have talked about impulse. So during impulse, what happens? Collision happens. When two moving bodies go head on, we call that one collision. And during collisions, two things happen. We have got change in momentum and change in kinetic energy. We all know that a moving body contains what we call kinetic energy. And provided it is moving, the body has got mass and it is moving at a certain velocity, so it has got both momentum and kinetic energy. So we have got two types of collision. One is called elastic, another one is called inelastic. Elastic collision is where the two bodies collide, both kinetic energy and momentum are conserved. In this case, for elastic collision, so let's have our elastic collision first. Elastic collision, one is that both momentum and kinetic energy are conserved. So in this case, what happened? In this case, the two bodies, what happens is that the two bodies collide. After colliding, they move away from each other in different velocities. Two bodies collide, and after collision, they move away from each other with different velocities. So let's see what happens actually and how the momentum and kinetic energy are changed. So let's have a body of mass M1 moving towards that side, and another body of mass M2 moving at that side. So as they are moving towards this side, so let's have the velocity of this body moving towards that side to be U1, and the velocity of body of mass 2 moving towards this side as U2. So as the two bodies move, they reach this point and collide. After colliding, body 2 moves away with, it has got the same mass, M2, but it now moves away with a different velocity, V2. Body 1 also moves away, the same mass, M1, but moves away with now a different velocity, V1. So let's see how the two exchanges their momentum and kinetic energy. So we know that body of M1, possesses kinetic energy given as a half. We know that kinetic energy in general is given as a half mv squared. So before collision, so we call this one body 1 and this is our body 2. Before collision, body 1 has the following properties. Kinetic energy of body 1 is given by a half m1, that's the mass of body 1, u1 squared, that's the velocity. And it also has momentum given as m1 u1, that is its momentum. Same time before collision still, body 2 has got kinetic energy given as a half m2 u2 squared, and it also has momentum given as m2 u2. We know that momentum is given in mass times acceleration. So after collision, what happens? We know that after collision, for elastic collision, momentum is not lost, kinetic energy is not lost. So it means that the two combines their momentum and kinetic energy during collision, and the output is still the same. So before collision, so this side, after collision, we have got body 2 now having kinetic energy, having kinetic energy given as a half. The mass is still the same, mass is still M1, but it is now moving with a different velocity, UB1 squared. And it has momentum, again now given as M1B1. Body 2 after collision also have got kinetic energy given as a half M2B2 squared, and the momentum given as m2v2. So we have got before collision and after collision, we have got both their momentum and kinetic energy. So what happens in collision is that we conserve both kinetic energy and momentum. So both before collision equation is, before collision we have body 1 adding its property to body 2, and the same output should be after collision, body 1 also sums to body 2 after this is before. So the kinetic energy of body 1 in before collision is a half m1 u1 squared. Then for body 2 it is a half m2 u2 squared. After collision, the properties of body 1 is a half m1 v1 squared. That one for body 2 is given as a half m2 v2 squared. So we can collect the like terms and factor out the common and have it that half is common into m1 v1 squared. So the u1 m1 u1 squared plus m2 u2 squared is equal to a half into m1 v1 squared plus m2 v2 squared. So we have got a half on both sides, such that this half and this half cancels out. You end up with m1 u1 squared plus m2 u2 squared is equal to m1 v1 squared plus m2 v2 squared. So this is what we call the equation of conservation of linear momentum and kinetic energy. And this one only happens, this case only happens when we have what we call elastic collision. And we say that during elastic collision, what happens? The two bodies move away from each other using different velocities. What about case two? The second case of collision is where we have what we call inelastic collision. So the same way we have got a case of elastic collision, we shall see the parameters of inelastic collision, then see how things come by into its case. So for inelastic collision, one thing that happens is that momentum is lost, but kinetic energy is conserved. What happens is that after collision, the two bodies collide. After collision, the two bodies join together. And move together in one direction. With a common velocity. For example, a large body like a tractor or a truck, large truck, collides head on with a small car. The truck will carry away the car and move with it towards one direction. That one is an example of inelastic collision. The two bodies combine together, then they move in one direction with one common velocity. So let's suppose have a big body M1 moving with a initial velocity U1, and a small body here M2 moving with initial velocity U2. They collide. After colliding, this one is moving towards this direction. This one suppose is moving towards this direction. After collision, they all move towards in this direction. So what happens? The big body combines with the small body. So this is M1, this is M2. Then they move with one velocity, that is V. So let's look at the properties of these bodies before and after collision and see how we lose momentum but we conserve kinetic energy. So just have the same way, before collision, before they collided, body 1, that is of mass M1, has got kinetic energy given as 1/2 m1 u1 squared, and it also has got momentum given as m1 u1. Then before collision still, body 2 of mass m2 has got kinetic energy given as 1/2 m2 u2 squared, and same time momentum given as, this is momentum, let's not confuse it with the mass, momentum given as m2 u2. So after collision, what happens? After collision, the two bodies combine together. So their masses are the sum. So the mass in this case is now equal to m2 plus m1. So kinetic energy after collision is now given as 1/2 into m2 plus m1. And they move with common velocity, that is V. They move with common velocity V. And we also know that before and after collision, all the energies are conserved. So before collision, if you have before collision here, B1 plus B2, all these parameters would give you after collision, that is B, because the two bodies combined. So you have got B as the sum of the two. So B1 properties are m1 u1 squared plus B2 was 1/2 m2 u2 squared to be equal to 1/2 into m1 plus m2 v squared. That is the common velocity. So we can factor out the common and add 1/2 is common into m1 u1 squared plus m2 u2 squared to be equal to 1/2 into m1 plus m2 v squared. So halves are common, you can drop them in that format. You end up with m1 u1 squared plus m2 u2 squared is equal to m1 m2 multiplied by v squared. So this is the equation for inelastic collision. This is what we call inelastic collision. So that's how it is driven. So in the next chapter, we'll see how we apply these collisions and their case studies in the next class.